No, I've got. Have I got more than? I think no. I might only have one steam engine car. I thought I had two. No, I've just got the A4. Problem is, the steam engine cabs don't really work so well because there's not really much behind you except blackness. Just put a black thing up. Right, call Benavi to enter the RETB system and obtain a shunt token, then couple the TTA tanks and OTA wagons in the CE siding. Right, so I'm going to move the chat out here.
Hopefully they'll give us a token in a minute. Let's wait for this train in front of us to get out of our way. No problem, BNSF. Right, we have our signal. We are clear to proceed up to Arisaig in front of us. Because we've got to go into the station, then come back and get our wagons here. So 2278 is actually the number of this radio unit. RETB, radio electronic token block. It's a system for it's like the old physical tokens they used, like the hook and hoop things they used to carry around, and this is the electronic version of it. Fridge Starling, what's wrong with 2278? Change the switch here. Go back and get those. Oh, hang on. There is only radio 2278 actually implemented, but yeah, the idea is if you had radio 2200, you would say 2200. I do like this 37th, absolutely superb.
This 37 comes with West Highland Line Extension, and the scripting is, the signalling stuff is specific to West Highland Line Extension. There are no other routes that have got RETB on them, and in reality there really aren't. I don't think there's one of the few British routes with RETB, certainly. The route needs to be enabled for it. It's part of the signalling system. You have to remind me how to do that, Ed. I've got no idea. Right, wait at the stop board at the end of platform 1 and obtain a token to proceed to Malaig. So we've got air goods. Should we be on then? Oh, is that on here? Hot plate? Not the hot plate you want me to do, is it? Oh, I can get to it now. Is it one of the... is this one, isn't it? Brake mode selector. What should I be on, Ed? Air goods. So we have it correct for once. It is air goods. Alright, I'll leave it on air goods then. Alright, let's get moving. Clear back to RSA, then we have to stop. Did everyone hear about the new Harry Potter novel that's coming out? Curse of the Child or something. I'm curious to see what that one's all about. Set 19 years in the future, after the end of Deathly Hallows. Curse of the Child, that's it, French style. Once we're in the platform, I can stop up at the signal and then I can request permission to proceed. Right, we have a token for Malaig. Let's get moving. Right, got 30. Right, we're clear of Arisaig now, and we are well on our way. Let's catch out, check some scenery from the outside, shall we? Oh, have I missed on the AWS? Right, I'm staying inside then. Shishatronica, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Brakes come off now. Cheers, Sergio K. Here they come. They're coming off slowly. There we go, 30 limit. Thought I'd just have a look outside and check out the view, but no. I'm going to put a thing in my rail driver code, so that in my app, so that when the AWS alarm goes off, it actually sounds a separate sound outside of the game. So that I don't have a problem with this anymore. It's driving me nuts. Down a 1 in 50. The radio in the black box, yeah, because I use that button down here, make call, to actually initiate the call. So the radio kinda works. You can change the volume of the radio as well. Very good, thank you, Venus F 9075. Wow, we've gained viewers for some reason. We're at the highest viewpoint so far, and it's 11 o'clock. Beautiful route, isn't it, Monty? This is West Highland Line Extension. Oh, the 156 with functional RETB would rock, Steve. Be a nice bit of variety for running on this route instead of always having 37. BNSF, can I show you the map? I will do my best. We'll see how many more emergency brake applications we get while we do. So this is us coming up here until we get to Malaig here. And then you've got Fort William, this is Speen Bridge, So this is where the West Highland Line South goes, and then you've got this line over here. This is all the way across the West Highland extension to Mallaig. Particularly beautiful area of the country. I already ran the Titfield route. I can't see who asked for that because it disappeared off the top of the screen, but I ran that just recently. It was very good and inspired me to finally go and see, buy the DVD and watch it, which I did today. Even did it with an appropriate scenario, consist as well. Can I open windows and doors? We shouldn't be running with the doors open, but we'll certainly get the windows down. Spads out of 5 rating for Titfield Thunderbolt. Ah, 5 Spads. 5 Spads. Excellent film. Thoroughly enjoyed it. Real what name? Thanks for the follow. Much appreciated. 4.9 to Mallaig. NASCAR 02? Yeah, I think that was NASCAR 02, possibly. I thought I missed. In which case, I do apologise. Thanks for the follow. Capitan Cripple, hello. Welcome to the stream. Good to have you with us. Spotter ready? Yes, this is a large logo 37. I'm going to dare an external view. There you go. Is it possible to have a pilot loco bring stock into a terminus and then follow the arriving train out? Not sure what you mean by following the arriving train. You mean follow the departing train? Needs more NSE, he says, more man. There's no reason why you couldn't have an AI train that with effectively a loco, you can have a loco, goes and gets some coaches, brings them into a platform, uncouples the coaches in the platform, pulls forward into the head shunt, and then the player train can come in and couple up, then go out, and then at some point after you're due out, the AE pilot then can come out and go into its own place. But if the player train hasn't gone, if he just sits in the platform, if there's a ground signal actually on the head shunt, then it should be fine. So yeah, you should be able to script all of that, that should be easy. David84, thank you for the host, much appreciated. Oh, I was just about to go outside. That looked like a rather nice little viaducty thing. Right, we're at 15 miles per hour now. Viaducty thing, is that the official title? It is indeed, Dave. That is the Scottish viaducty thing. Well, we're a long way from Glenfinnan Viaduct tomorrow, man. Long way from Glenfinnan. We're towards the very end of the route here. Got a reduction to 10 coming up. DJ Techno, I think you should definitely get your coat. Dear, oh dear. Yep, that was Minion Crossing. Me do, me do, me do. Back up on the 30 limit now, we've gone through that station. Whenever I start streaming, my Skype just gets spammed with Skype messages. Quite know why that would be. Yeah, Francois, that was one of the reasons I decided it was a good one to pick. Because, as you say, most scenarios start at one end, either, or they are so long because they try to do the entire scenario. Yes, you can put audio in a scenario BNS. If what you can't do then is upload it to Workshop, I don't think the audio files get uploaded. Darkness Monster, I have no idea what time the OMG stream, the OMR stream will be. Probably be Sunday sometime. Mostly because I arrive at Mum and Dad's on Saturday. I'm trying to get the stream in for the afternoon. It's a bit of a rush. And I kind of want to see if I can spend some of the afternoon doing some work on the layout. Maybe get that Hipple chipped as well. Yeah, please do, Francois. That's picked up. Cheers, darkness. What's allowed to be scripted in a workshop scenario? HTML files get uploaded and images. So you can do your pop-ups. You can do anything the script can do inside its own Lua file, but I don't think you can do videos and audio and things like that uploaded to workshop. I thought audio did work, but I have a sneaky suspicion from a scenario I tried recently it doesn't. Try it, see what happens. No, Victor. Right, coming up in Malleg East. Good night, Dark. I haven't already said so. Fixed distance. Oh, sorry, darkness, you're right. What you were saying was you were. It was tomorrow you were talking about, not right now. I'm only paying sort of a casual attention to the. Chat, because while I've got this radio, it's right in the way of where my chat normally sits, so I have to move the chat off the screen. And Mr. Train Cow, technically yes, whether or not the scenario system will be happy about it or not is a separate issue, however. The thing to do is to try it, and if you get away with it, then great. You should be able to actually, because if you think about it, if you've got two locos like HST, you can switch to the other end of the HST alright. So yeah, you should be alright. I don't know what would happen if you uncoupled the original loco. So if you had an 08 that coupled up to a train, and then you changed loco to the 47 on the train, uncoupled the 08 and then carried on, left the original loco behind. That would be interesting to try. I don't know whether you'd get away with that. So we're going to Malleg Loop Siding. Now I have a sneaky suspicion I might need to set a point somewhere. Malleg Loop Siding is there.
the low curve siding. That's the loop siding just there.
Ed, I don't think so. I think we had the 08 with us. Because it was moving train around, I think. I can't remember. You might be right. I know the one you mean. Mole Man, you should email support if you have problems. Why can't you set up a scenario where it stretches cab views? Because there isn't a way of instructing, there isn't a scripty way of selling it, of doing the control plus control minus thing. Will I be using the London Brighton route of Brand Model World? I've no idea. We should be probably showing what people want to see. It's not like a UK Train Sim exhibition. If that's what you're used to, don't expect it to be the same idea. Can't everything be done with scripts, no. Are we all in yet? Are we all gonna get in? No, we're not. As long as we're clear of this point, we should be fine. Alright. Cool. In that case, I should just be able to... couple. Good. Wait at the buffer stop and set the route round. Oh, we need to make a call. Right. Going to Malaig East.
How does the radio know? It's quite complex. You have to set it all up in the scenario with markers and so forth. It's fully covered in the manual, if I remember rightly. OMG trains, this is class 37 in a large logo, 37/4, it's the one that comes with West Highland Line extension. There are no red signals on this route, Dave, they're just flashing blue ones or solid blue ones. Well, that's a really nice touch. All the manual junctions for this have been put here. Shunt the OTA wagons is the loading bank siding. So we're going across, so we need to couple to the to those. Switch over to that. That's nicely. It's just simple animation, but it's very good. What's the meaning of the blue and solid blue? Effectively, they're telling you whether or not you can proceed. Basically, so flashing blue is means that means that you can proceed, and a solid blue means that you can't proceed. TPWS indicator. Yes, that's it. Whether TPWS isn't energised or something like that. Right, you're off now, are you, darkness? In that case, good night. Gorbob. Right, now we're going to Maleg East, which is back to here. Where is this loading siding? Ah, they're over there, okay. Fine, let's go back out. Other end of the train, please. We've got flashing blue, so good to carry on.
Yeah, those seagulls are kind of annoying, aren't they? I've got no idea about release time, I'm afraid, Tarog. Early morning light up duties at Bridge North on Sunday, GWR. Nice. Enjoy. Right, so we're dropping these off here, so change the point and change that point. Now we're going the correct way. Majestic Dogface, yeah, Feather River Canyon is looking awesome. I'm looking forward to getting that running. I'm going to be running that on the stream some as well. We are dropping these off at the loading bank, which is just here. Now, what are we dropping off, just to double check? The OTA wagons. Oh, hang on. I think I've fluffed this up. Because I bet I have to go back and get the other wagons. Yeah, I've got a couple of TTA tanks separately. Yeah, I kind of fluffed this up. Is there a way I can rescue this? Yeah, there is a way I can kind of rescue this. Oh no! Let me tab. It will. Because I need to get those ones stuffed in another siding. Of course, if that train leaves while I'm doing this, then I'll have a different problem entirely. I tabbed, Steve. I tabbed. is either going to go well or horrifically wrong. I think it's going to go horrifically wrong. Driver of the 37's thinking, what? No. That one and that one are a couple. Proved again. Right, let's do this. Drop the OTA wagons off. At this point, I'm just not caring about speeding too much. Everything else has gone wrong. Who cares if we speed a bit? Alright, that's the OTA wagons in place. That junction, come back, get those wagons, and then what I'll do is I'll uncouple them and recouple them on the other siding, and that should trigger it. Hopefully. Fingers crossed. Now routed back into the wagons. It's okay, you don't need to worry about that. Don't worry, you're pretty little head. Okay, couple up. Go forward, release the brakes, pop them on. And release that and those. Right, we're going off to Malaig East now. Tab that signal. Good evening, Gouger. Just in time to see me make a total fluff of the scenario. Is this the new Loco 374? It's the one that comes in West Highland Line extensions. It's got the radios and so forth. How much longer is this scenario? Not too much longer. I've just got to put these wagons somewhere. I too will be happy to hear the end of these. Oops, no, don't put the brakes off. Hear the end of these pesky birdie things. Think of the entertainment value. Always think of the entertainment. The entertainment is king. You're not here to be bored.
by precision and competency. You're here to be entertained by incompetency, imprecision. Shunt the TTA tanks into a good siding. You may have to press tab. Well, first thing I've got to do is go and get the TTA tanks. Oh, these birds! Note to self, never make a scenario at Malak. So we're actually dropping them off in there, okay? Right, so let's just pin the brake on release and then come back up to it. Right, now we're going to Malak Local. Now our scenario is back on track, folks. We may have rescued this. Got a flashing blue, so we're okay. Enough of us in there. No, we're not in the siding yet. There! Right, we're in the siding now. Drop off, so I need to change that one, and then we come back and top the loco there. We're almost there, folks. We are almost there.
why we've been wonder why we'll be having trouble moving. Are we in? I think we're in. Malag Loco side. Off we go, folks. We're nearly there. Right, we should put the siding in here, and we are done. What's my favourite Thompson DLC? I don't know. This is what this is definitely high on the list. Alright, let's see how we got on. We got on fine, it was fine, no one saw anything wrong with that scenario. It went beautifully well. There you go, 6 out of 6 destinations, 20 out of 20 rail vehicles. Boom, let's ignore all that other stuff down there. Let's not press replay either, that would be silly. Right, number 3. What's number 3? St Albans to Sutton, Midland Main Line. They're still going, even though we're in the menu. Go away!